What's your broader approach towards investing in China right now? Because some analysts on the street, David, are talking about how the play out with the markets currently is a reminder of the bust that we witnessed in 2015. Is that a fair comparison?
Sure. Well, I like to first point out a distinction between the rally that we've seen in the U.S. Versus China. The U.S. equities have really rallied since March due to the Fed's put, or they view it as the Fed as being the buyer of last resort. Now, the China A share rally that we've seen in the past month has been due to improving economic fundamentals. Now, that being said, I'd argue that the Chinese rally is more sustainable than the one that we've seen in the U.S. So China is experiencing a very solid economic recovery, and that sentiment may continue to support Chinese equities even at these levels. So meanwhile, there is a growing concern in the U.S.'s ability to control the spread of the coronavirus. Now, stepping back to the recent A-share market performance, I continue to be constructive on both A-shares as well as Chinese equities across the board for two main reasons. Number one, we've seen that Chinese economic rebound continues, and it's one of the few economies in the world that will eke out a positive GDP growth for this year. And secondly, the A-share valuations remain reasonable despite the recent run-up. Although the four 12-month P valuations on A-shares remain on the high side when viewed historically, that's due to the company's earnings being much lower this year due to coronavirus. However, if you normalize the earnings on a 24-month basis, the current valuations are trading around 14 times around historical ranges. Now, it's important, though, to keep an eye on the topic that you just mentioned, tremendous retail enthusiasm that has recently piled into the onshore stock market. And the government has actually advocated for a healthy bull market last month. But the unintended consequence has been a surge in retail sentiment, and the stock market turnover velocity is now at seeing to unwanted margin financing that you just referenced. So this is a key metric that I watch out for, since it signals speculative investing, which we saw back in 2015. Although the margin lending percentage has been rising recently, it's not close to where it was back then, since regulators have recently clamped down on illegal margin lending businesses, as they don't want to see a repeat of what happened back then. So I believe that the market is still on much firmer footing than it was back in 2015. And so to sum up, I think that China's overall economic recovery continues to be solid and also the envy of the world. And I believe that the improving fundamentals will continue to support Chinese equities and that the market has perhaps another 15 to 20% more to go.